Hello and welcome back to my channel. I know I've been attempting to rock the space buttons a lot lately. They used to be a skill that I had, and then I lost the skill, so I'm trying to get it back. So that's why you're going to see them on me a lot, because I really want to get good at them again. We are going to do a March Favorites video. There's not a lot of makeup here, and not a lot, I mean, I literally have one makeup item in front of me, because I haven't been wearing a lot of makeup, because when you're self-isolating, you don't really need to wear makeup. And that's that on that. First favorite, this shirt that Shelby bought me for my birthday. Look how perfect it is. I haven't actually had the chance to wear it out yet because we're not going anywhere, but I just love it so much. She bought it at like a local thrifty store, and I had showed it to her on Instagram because I loved it and I wanted to go buy it. And before I had a chance to buy it, she bought it for me for my birthday. So I think it's so cute. So that's my first favorite. My second favorite, back when we were leaving the house, I was wearing this e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer every day. And I think I bought this actually at the end of February? Middle of February? And I love it. It's just, I struggle to find a con of this concealer because it's lightweight, it's got a fair amount of coverage, it doesn't get gross and crackly and crinkly and old looking on me, and I just love it. Mine is in the shade Fair Warm, and I do have a Tuesday review on this. If it hasn't gone up yet, it'll be up in the coming weeks. So this is great. If you need a concealer, the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. I do have a skincare favorite though. I forgot how much I love this L'Oreal Pure Clay Mask, the black one. There's a couple different varieties, but I've only tried the black one. And I think this is my third pot of this. My second pot of this ran out a long time ago, and I forgot that I loved it. And then I recently went out and rebought it. And it just like, it really, when it dries on your face, it dries really, really hard and really crusty. So if you have sensitive skin, do not try this. It's gonna hurt. Like, don't do it. But I don't have sensitive skin, so when I use it, I just really feel like not only does it really get off any sort of dead skin that's on my face, but I feel like it really gets into my pores and really, like, cleans them out. I just feel like my whole face looks less clogged after I've done this mask. So I don't do this mask any more than, like, once every week and a half-ish, because I feel like it's so intense. But when I do it, my skin feels so much nicer after. And then, after I've used it, I use my The Ordinary Rosehip Oil, and the next morning, my skin feels so great. So that is my pro tip. Use a really hydrating oil after you use a charcoal mask, and your skin will thank you for that. Something I want to mention quickly. So my younger sister acquired a worm on a string through, somehow, I don't understand. And my cat loved it. It was like her favorite toy. So I decided to go on Wish in like the end of January and see if I could buy some worm on a string for cheap for my cat to play with. And I ordered a bag of 48 worm on a string for about $10. And they finally arrived a couple of weeks ago. And she hasn't even wrecked one yet, but it is her favorite toy. If I pick it up, like, her pupils go massive and she's like crazy for it. So between the worm on a string and her laser pointer, like, that's it. Like, those are, like, all the toys she plays with now. And she goes nuts for them, and she hasn't gotten tired of them. So if you have a cat, try worm on a string. I have 44 of them now if you want some, because I gave a couple away. But still, like, this is her favorite, absolute favorite cat toy. I have another story for you about Lena, actually. She went for her annual checkup on March 14th. And my older sister Sam takes her because honestly, it is just so much easier for an able-bodied person to take a cat to the vet than it is for me. So Sam takes Lena, I just give her my credit card and I say, pay whatever you gotta pay. And we found out at this vet appointment that the vet that she had last year put caution on her file. So now in the future, whenever Lena goes back to the vet, I have to sedate her before she goes. They gave me like wolf pills and I have to like break them open and get her to drink the liquid that's inside. And I know that it's for her own well-being, because the reason she's aggressive when she's there is because she's stressed and she's scared, but I can't get over the fact that I have to sedate my cat for her to go to the vet. Like, I look at Lena, and of course she's a little bit testy sometimes. Like, she's not the world's sweetest cat, okay? I've definitely had some marks on me before, and I definitely have some scars, but I didn't think she was, like, sedate-worthy. My poor kitty. That was actually right before my birthday, and it was the same day, March 14th, I was supposed to go to the Butterfly Conservatory, and that was like the only thing that I was doing for my birthday, but obviously things got shut down that weekend, so we weren't able to go, which is okay. I mean, it's kind of a bummer, but I mean, we'll go when the world gets back to some kind of normal. It's just sad, because I was gonna go, and I was gonna like vlog it, and it was gonna be a video for you, but now we have to wait. That's okay. I can wait. Let's get off that topic into something a little more fun. Which thing here should I talk about next? How about these? Because I also ordered these before the world exploded. So these are from an artist. Her name is, I'm going to pronounce it as Kanchy. K-A-N-N-C-H-Y. And I ordered these from her website a while ago. And I ordered 5 because I have sticker anxiety. That is a real thing, I've decided. It's like when you have a sticker and you love it, and you're like, what if where I decide to put this is the wrong place to put this, and then I regret it. So I ordered 5 of her stickers so that I could place a couple somewhere and not have anxiety about it. But it's a wheelchair, and it's full of plants, and I'm, you know, attempting to be a plant lady. I have lots of plants. I have now a planted terrarium for Roger. It's completely planted. That is a video that you will see at some point. And I just thought it was so cute. You hardly ever see, like, wheelchair merch anywhere. So I just had to buy it and to support her. I just love it. And then speaking of plants, I have to tell you the weirder story. So this is a ZZ plant. I actually bought the ZZ plant from Zayre's. And I saw it, and I wanted to buy it, and I didn't buy it, and I had regrets. And then the quarantine kicked in, and I was like, I just really want to go rescue the ZZ plant. Which is so stupid, and, like, not the priority. And I don't know why my brain works this way, but I was like, I really just want to go rescue that ZZ plant. So I waited until March 20th because Animal Crossing launched for the Switch, and I was going to have to leave the house to go get it. Now, please understand that here we did not have the lineups that they had in Toronto at EB Games for the Animal Crossing Switch. I believe when I got to EB Games, there were 3 groups of 2 people who were all very spaced, waiting outside, and then me. So there were 7 people total, but we were all really spaced. It was done really responsibly. The EB Games worker, she came out, she said, we're not open as a store. We're just open to sell people their Animal Crossing pre-orders if they pre-ordered. So we're going to take people in 1 at a time, and that's it. So that was, I thought that was done really well and really, like, within the rules. Because at first I was a little bit frustrated at EB Games for being open, even though I had put $10 down for my Animal Crossing pre-order. It was a little bit like, you should be closed, everything else is closed. But I think they kept open for Animal Crossing and for Doom, so I like how they did the release, and I have respect for that, but I think they should close now. Anyway, so when I went to EB Games to buy Animal Crossing, I, in that same trip, ran into Zayre's, bought the ZZ plant that I wanted to save, and they came home. And this is my ZZ plant, and I love her, and I feel like I rescued her, you know, from the quarantine. I just love her. I don't have another ZZ plant, so I saw her, and I just love her. And that's my story about my ZZ plant. She's like, sometimes I'm sitting at my computer, and I just pick her up, and I just hold her like this. Because she's, like, perfect size to fit, like, right in between my boobs. She's, like, my emotional support plant. Like, I just need her sometimes. That's my stupid story about my plant. And also my stupid story about Animal Crossing. So I told it in my video last week, but I'll tell it again briefly. I didn't buy a Switch for the longest time because I convinced myself that, you know, they were going to have an Animal Crossing Switch, and I was going to buy that because I regretted not getting the Animal Crossing DS. And then when they finally announced the Animal Crossing Switch, I talked myself out of buying it because it was too expensive, and I wasn't going to be able to play it, I wasn't going to have time, blah, blah, blah. Mind you, at that point, I didn't know that we were going to be in quarantine for an indefinite amount of time, so I wasn't totally wrong. I probably wouldn't have enough time to play it, you know, otherwise. But my friend Alyssa knows me, and she knew that I would regret not pre-ordering it, so she pre-ordered it knowing I was going to change my mind, and then she let me pay her back so that I would have the Switch. So I bought the Animal Crossing Switch from Alyssa, and then my sister Sam bought me the Animal Crossing case for my birthday, and so now I have the beautiful Animal Crossing Switch in the case with Animal Crossing in it, and that is the only game that I own, and probably the only game that I'm ever going to own, to be honest with you, because it's the only one that I'm interested in. That one and Katamari Damacy, to be honest with you. If you've never played Katamari Damacy and you have a Switch, I promise you, it's so much fun. It's so stupid. You're literally a little alien dude, and you roll a ball, and you pick things up. And the big King of All Cosmos guy tells you how big you need your little ball of stuff to be. And you have to get it that big by the end. And eventually you get so big that you're able to pick up people. And there's, like, little children flailing because they're stuck to your big old ball thing. And it's amazing. It's one of my favorite games ever. I think the first one that I remember, at least, of Katamari Damacy was for the PS2. And I love that game, so I'll probably play that one too. But for right now, it's just Animal Crossing. You might notice a little bit of a different world behind me. I did already mention that the terrarium is now bioactive, which means it is planted. There are little bugs in there to eat mold and stuff. But you also notice that I have a fish tank in here now. Henry, who was the subject of one of my videos past, I upgraded his tank And then this happened to the world, so my friend Shelby and I, same Shelby who bought the shirt, she is going to be working from home now as well. So there was going to be nobody to feed Henry, so she rescued Henry. She broke him out of jail. She brought him here, and now he lives here beside his brother. And I have only caught Lena looking at him a couple of times, but fortunately she kind of understands me, so I told her no, and then I tried to distract her, and she kind of hasn't really done anything beyond that. So hoping that's okay. I put my other container of isopods on top of the tank just to kind of make it a little bit taller to kind of defer her from even trying, so I think we're going to be okay. She's kind of a jerk. She's a caution kitty, if you will, but she's not really mischievous in that way. She's more outwardly aggressive rather than, like, mischievous and secret, you know? The only other thing I want to mention is, have you watched Tiger King on Netflix? This show is unreal. I went into it just thinking it was going to be, like, some weirdo guy who owns a lot of tigers and a documentary about him. That is the furthest thing from the truth. It is about a whole bunch of different people, and it is like a soap opera, drama, reality TV show, and where we end up I had no idea we were going to end up there from where we started at the beginning, and I don't want to spoil anything, and I really, even if I was okay with spoiling things, I don't know how to describe it, because so much stuff happens. It is tiger owner versus animal activist, sort of, kind of, if you can even call her that, to be honest with you. While you're home and you're quarantined, watch Tiger King on Netflix. It will blow your mind. It is so weird. It is the weirdest thing I've ever seen in my life. And for that reason, I hope you like it. It's not intelligent. Like, it's not like one of those documentaries where you learn things. It is just weird. And for that reason, I hope you like it. But that's pretty much it. That's what I've been doing, is holding my plant, playing Animal Crossing, watching Tiger King, working, of course, editing YouTube videos, of course, but that's no different than usual. So please let me know what you have been doing in the month of March. What have you been doing while you've been home? What have you been loving? Tell me something positive. I wish we could share comments, or photos in comments, because I would just, like, love pictures of your animals and that sort of thing. I could see photos and comments going south really fast on some of the bigger channels, but on, like, my channel, I'm like, I just want to see pictures of your dogs and your cats and your animals, because you get to see my gaggle of creatures all the time, but, you know, I wish I could see yours. So let me know in the comments below, you know, what's going on with you? What's good? You know, what do you love? What are some happy things? What are some things you've been playing with? Some plants, some animals, some video games, some skincare, some makeup, whatever realm you fall into, just let me know. Thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and you subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed already, and I will see you next time. Bye!